Okay, I know why you're here. You know why you're here. We both read the title. You're here because you're turning on Global Groove and nothing's happening. You're clicking shuffle and you're not really hearing any difference. Or maybe you're hearing too much. Or maybe you just don't understand why there's 10,000 different ways to add shuffle and groove to your track. Well, my name is Alex, if you don't know that already, and I'm gonna be explaining this. Okay, so first of all, let's have a look at what I've created here. And it's just a basic drum beat. So let's see. I've added a hi-hat on every 16th note. Let me just shorten this and make it one bar long, okay? I've added a hi-hat on every 16th note. And you know that because there's 16 of them evenly spread apart against one bar. All right, I've added a kick drum on every 8th note, because there's 8 of them spread evenly over one bar, and I've added a snare on the ands. Okay, let's have a listen to it. Very basic. Let me just loop this. If you want to just loop a section, just click the title, Command L. Okay, so if I wanted this one looped, Command L, and it stretches this out, it turns on the loop. Okay, but I just want that one looped, Command L. Okay, very straight. Nothing happening there. So what is shuffle really? Well, shuffle is just the act of moving the every other note closer to its following notes. Okay, so if I add shuffle there, you see it's just taken this hi-hat and moved it a little bit closer to this stack right here. Let's listen. Right, it's a little bit more than that. This is called a 16th shuffle because it's taking every other 16th note and moving it closer to the following note. Okay, if it was an 8th note shuffle, it would take every 8th note and move it closer to the next 8th note, so it would be this guy. But that's not what let's not delve into that just yet. Okay, so up here in your play, you have enable groove. If that's not checked, it hides the menu. You can pin this to your menu there. I pinned it. I don't really know why, because I'm always going to want to change these parameters here. And this is where you select 8th note or 16th note. So remember, is it taking every other 8th note or every even 8th note and moving it closer to the next 8th note, or is it the 16th note? So every even 16th note and moving it closer to the next 16th note. And furthermore, how much is it doing that? If it's 100%, it's putting those notes right on top of the next one, okay? If it's 0%, they're basically staying the same. So I put mine to 50%. Let's get 50 there, okay? The next thing that you'll notice is accent, and you'll hear this in a second, but this is more with volume. This more is concerned about the volume. Am I accenting the quarter notes on the odds or the evens? And I'll show you what that sounds like in a sec, because it'll make a lot more sense. Okay, so with enable groove enabled and the shuffle set at 50% on a 16th note, let's have a listen to what this does. So I click this and I turn on shuffle, okay? Okay, so it sounds the exact same as if I turn it off, put on my quantize shuffle. See? Okay, so that's one way to do it. You can select a clip, you can set the parameters here, and you can just add the shuffle. Now, accent. If I turn this up, I'll play this and I'll slowly turn it up, and you'll hear the volume difference between the kicks and the snares. Okay, let's have a listen. And if I go the other direction, let me adjust this a little bit. Why don't we put it on 16th note, and we'll turn it up a lot so you can really hear it. Set this to 0 and let's have a listen. Okay, so the kick and snare are really loud, and the hi-hat's only loud when the kick and snare go off. If I go the other way, hi-hat's really loud in between the kicks and the snares. The kicks and the snares have been turned down. All right. Back to zero. And I'll turn that off. Okay. This track, I thought I would create it and show you what it sounds like, the difference between the two, but I kind of already did that, so I'm going to just delete that. Okay, so this one, we can quantize it. So I don't have global shuffle on. I can even turn it off here, but that's okay. We can add shuffle just to this one track. Okay, so let's highlight them all, Command A. Okay, make sure you click in here first and then Command A. And now to bring up the quantize options, let's see, it looks like I already quantized this. Yes. So let me get rid of that. Quantize shuffle. Sorry about that. Okay. Bring this loop down. Okay, click in here, Command A. So there's no global shuffle on anymore. Okay. This track, turn it off. And we want shuffle on this, but we don't want global shuffle. Well, that's easy. You can Command A to get them all, and then Option Q to bring up the quantize settings. And here you can choose again. Do you want a 16th note shuffle, 8th note, quarter note? The further you go down, the more dramatic of a shuffle it's going to get, because in here, it's only moving every other 16th note to the following 16th note. Whereas if you go down to, say, a quarter note, it's a lot further of a distance. You're moving every other quarter note to the next quarter note, and it's a lot more dramatic. So why don't we add 50% shuffle? So it's going to move these notes halfway to the next, the even notes halfway to the next 16th note. Let's have a look. And there it is. Okay. Let me turn, I'm going to shorten the note length a little bit here. All right, whatever. I'll just leave it. No, I don't want to leave it. There we go. Okay, let's have a listen. Before and after, before and after. So it's basically the same sound, same feel, and it's that way because we set the quantize options, 16th note, 50%, as the same as the groove, the global groove. Okay, here's the thing that's weird that I don't understand. They call it swing in their manual, but according to music theory, shuffle is when you take this note and move it. Ooh, let me undo some of this here. They call it shuffle, and that's proper because shuffle is taking every other note, depending on what grid you choose, and moving it further this way. Swing is technically when you take this note and move it closer this way. And I haven't found a way to do that yet. Global shuffle only moves it in this direction, right? But I would like a swing, because if you were talking to a properly trained drummer and you told them you want to swing your beat, they're going to think, okay, we'll take every other note and we'll move it closer to this note, okay? And if you tell them you want shuffle, they're going to go this way. But there's no swing, really. Highlight these, right? Shuffle, humanize. It's not there. Let's see. Yeah, kind of weird, right? Well, that's besides the point. So now you're wondering probably, why would I use global shuffle instead of just shuffling the tracks with the quantize function that I want to be shuffled? Well, there's two simple answers here. One is that it's much easier if you set the parameters in the global shuffle and you have a whole bunch of drum tracks and you have a whole bunch of bass lines and stuff like that. You can just apply those exact same parameters to every single track that you want them to be on. And you don't have to go into each one independently. Click down here, Command A, Option Q, set the parameters, click OK, right? Instead, you can just click it, add the shuffle, and you're done. The only difference is that you don't see it happening when you do that, when you use the global shuffle. You just have to trust that it's happening, and you can hear that it's happening. But one interesting thing I thought of was, okay, well, here I have a pad. Let me mute this and play this for a sec. Oop. Turn off the arpeggiator. Here's my pad. Okay. Right, nothing fancy. Okay, with an arpeggiator on. No shuffle. Turn global shuffle off. Right, very straight. If I turn on global shuffle or groove and turn on the shuffle, look at that. It knows. The arpeggiator knows that I want to shuffle it. So, and I thought that's pretty interesting because it's not just surface deep. Bitwig actually knows when I apply global groove to something, it's going to affect the devices even inside here that are altering the note patterns, like the arpeggiator, for example. So that's super cool, because if I were to add an arpeggiator on a pad like this, and I had everything else shuffled, but this was playing straight, that would sound weird. And then I'd be left going in here and changing it to whatever to try and to match it, and that would be awkward. But instead, it knows, and I can just apply the global shuffle, and there you have it, right? And so now these will match. Oops, turn the global shuffle on here. Pretty cool, right? Okay. Let's go down here, mute this guy. Let's highlight these notes. Option Q to bring it up. Okay, so I just want to make it clear now. If I hit editor and I use the shuffle, what's happening is it's taking this value. It's taking the session value, which is 16th notes, okay? Go back to Option Q. If I go to custom, it just basically allows me to change it between which grid or which type of shuffle I'm gonna choose and whether it's straight or triplet and so on and so forth, okay? So that's really the only difference between editor and custom. Editor is easy if you know you're going to apply it to that 16th note grid that you're on now. And custom is if you want to screw it up a bit and make it sound a little more interesting or different. Okay, here's your shuffle amount, i.e. how far is that every other or every even note moving towards the next one or not. Okay, I wonder if I can go in the negatives. No, I can't. Oh, that'd be cool. Because then that would be swing, right? It would be in a different thing. Okay. Humanize, basically, well, I don't know if this kind of relates to the video, but humanize is going to alter the timing and the velocity of each note to make it sound more like humans, because when a human plays a hi-hat, it's not the exact same intensity perfectly on the beat each time. That's a little different than shuffle. Shuffle is consistently moving every other beat. This one's just gonna put it off the grid a little bit along with the velocity, okay? We won't talk about that right now. I just thought, well, it's there, we'll explain it, okay? All right, so remember, yeah, when you enable groove, that's when you see this menu, and that's when you can make the decision. Am I gonna move every other eighth note or every other 16th note towards its following partner? And how much am I gonna do that? 50%, 100%, it's up to you. You can add just a little touch of it, which is kind of groovy too. And then the accent, how much of the volume am I going to affect? So here's an interesting thing. If I put this to 100, and I'll have it on 16th notes, okay? And now I take the accent, let's just solo this. I take the accent and turn up to 100. It nearly takes out some of the hi-hats and really brings up the kick and the snare. And that's at 100% of this value. So if this was at 50%, for example, okay, let's listen. It is only 100% of 50%. If that makes any sense, okay? So that means that this is the accent is affecting this by 50%, even though it says 100. If I went to 50%, 50% of 50% is 25%. So now you'll get a 25% accent. Okay? All right, I hope that clears it up a little bit for you. And remember, the quantize groove function is really good if you just want to groove one track. Maybe you just want your drums to be grooved and you don't want to have the mistake of accidentally hitting this on any other tracks. Okay, that's fine. Just go in here on one of your drum tracks, click down there, Command A, Option Q, set your shuffle amount, Okay, that's good for me. And then you can copy those drums out and put them in all your other drum machines. And the reason why that's good is because this actually moves the note, right? So now if I were to copy this MIDI, if I were to copy this down, it's going to bring those notes that are now moved down with it. Whereas with the global groove, say for example, get rid of this and I'll get rid of that actually too. So this one is not quantized on the micro level, meaning it's not quantized in its MIDI editor. What's happening is the groove is just getting its groove from the parameters I set in the global groove. So it still sounds swung. But now if I bring this down by holding option, click and drag, and this shuffle is not on, well, I'm not gonna get that shuffle anymore. Right? Oh, I'm still getting the accent. Sorry. I'm not getting that shuffle anymore. And if it doesn't automatically turn on the shuffle, which I think it always does, then you're going to be wondering, well, how come this drum sounds different than that one? Right? Okay. So the difference being, if I click this, turn it off, and I don't have groove on, but I want groove, option A, quantize it. Now, if I drag this down by option clicking, dragging it down, they both have the same quantized groove in there. Okay, it's shuffle, it's not swing. If you want to swing your notes, well, I guess we're just kind of left with grabbing these. I would like to figure out how to add swing because it's super cool and it sounds great. But if you want to add swing, you're basically left with taking these and dragging them closer to this way and then. Well, that's pretty bizarre. Oh yeah, shoot, I have both of them. Right? Very similar. Very similar. It's how do I explain the difference? Well, like you can see the difference between the two. The swing is da 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 and shuffle is da 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 da. Okay? That's it. That's the only difference, but it'll make a difference one day when you're working and programming drums. Okay? All right. And I hope you found it cool like I did that it actually affects the arpeggiator. I think that's just super cool. So like that just tells me that any of the note modifications like the transposition map or whatever, or maybe not the transposition map, but any of the like the note things the for a synth are all going to be affected by the global groove. And so that's a major reason why you might use the global groove and shuffle rather than just on the quantize level, right? Because if I wanted this pattern without the arpeggiator, this pattern here, well, like I'd have to go in here and I'd have to chop up these notes and I'd have to add it in manually so that the MIDI reflects that, and then I'd have to quantize the groove, the shuffle, or add the shuffle in later. But it saves you the trouble. It knows, oh, you got an arpeggiator and you got global groove on. We'll just apply it if you want that, or you can just go straight. Okay, pretty cool. I hope you found that interesting. Please subscribe to my channel. Okay, I would really like that if you did. And if not, I mean, that's your decision, I guess. It's just a lot of work to do this. And I'd really appreciate it. If you have any more comments or questions or anything to add to this video, definitely leave them in the comment section below. I'd love to hear them. Let's chat it out. Let's get, educational here. You can email me. That's perfectly fine. Here, you know what I haven't done in a while? I haven't done this. Up it up. Let's put global shuffle on this sucker. How about that? Isn't that just beautiful thing. All right, do you want to quantize shuffle that? Hey, turn it up a bit here. There we go. Look at that. There you go. I quantize shuffled a please subscribe for you. Anyway, all right, guys, I'll see you in the next video. Take care.